Hello, my name is Keshwani. That's K-E-S-H-W-A-N-I, Keshwani. Today we'll have our fourth lesson in a series of six videos on the topic of ratios and proportions. Ratios and proportions in the first three videos number 1, 2, and 3, we did 25 problems. Today we'll do problem number, today we'll begin with problem number 26. Problem number 26, as you can see, is already on the blackboard. Let's take a look at it, shall we? It says, a jar contains red, blue, green, and yellow marbles. We're further told that the ratio of red to yellow is 2 to 5. Ratio of green to red is 2 to 1. Ratio of blue to yellow is 3 to 5. And the question goes on to ask us, what is the ratio of red to blue? What's the ratio of red to blue? I just noticed that here I'm using capital B for blue, and here I use a small b for blue. Let's be consistent. Not that it makes any difference, but it might help. Blue to yellow. And furthermore, what's the ratio of red to blue? And second question, what's the ratio of blue to green? Of course, in the real exam, they're not going to ask for two of them. Obviously, they're going to ask just one ratios. And in the real exam also, they try to present the question in a little bit more sophisticated way. Instead of talking about a red, blue, green, and yellow marbles, in the actual exam, the question, when it appeared, this question appeared, it appeared something like, they were talking about a school, and in the school they were talking about the ratio of we have four classes, freshmen, sophomore, juniors, or seniors. And they go on to tell us different ratios, the ratio of freshmen to juniors, junior to seniors, freshmen to sophomores, and then they go on to ask us one ratio at the end. But the idea does not change. The idea does not change, the concept does not change, the methodology does not change. It's just that instead of colors, they have classes, freshmen, sophomore, juniors, and seniors, as I said, instead of having four colors. What I want you to do right now is to pause the video, do the problem as we always do yourself. Once you have done so, resume the video and then compare your work against the work that you and I will do together in a few seconds time. I'll give you 5 seconds to do just that, to be able to pause and unpause the video, okay? And then we'll do it together after you've done it. Here we go. All right, let's begin then. Let's see what we know. The ratio of red to yellow, we know the ratio of red to yellow, we are told, is 2 to 5. We furthermore know that green to red is 2 to 1. 2 to 1. And finally, blue to yellow, we are told, is 3 to 5. What is the question asking for? We are interested in red to blue. Do you see any ratio which contains red and blue? Well, here's the first one that has red in it, but it also has a yellow. So if we're going to use this one, we have to somehow get rid of the yellow. So we're looking for something that involves, not only we need the blue, but we also need yellow in it. Blue and yellow. Oh, right there. So if you take red to yellow times blue to yellow, as you can clearly see, that's not going to get us anywhere, because what we're going to end up is R times B versus R over R squared. That's not what we want. So instead of multiplying the two, we will divide the two ratios. So if we divide the two ratios, what do we end up with? We end up with red to yellow times, we have to take a reciprocal of it, times yellow over blue. Yellows are going to cancel out and we can end up red to blue. We're going to end up with red to blue, which is exactly what we want. And we're done. So let's do that. Red to yellow was 2 to 5 times, this is blue to yellow, remember, we do not want blue to yellow, we need yellow to blue, so we have to take a reciprocal of it, you have to remember it. So 3 over 5 becomes 5 over 3, and 5 are going to cancel out, and the answer is 2 to 3. The ratio that we're looking for is 2 to 3, we're done. Let's move on to the next one, shall we? The next ratio we want is blue to green. Again, we're looking for something that has blue in it. I see a blue right here, it has a blue in it. And we need a green. There is a green here. But notice what happens here. Here we have a green and here we have a blue, but we don't have a common element at the bottom. This is yellow and this is red. That's not going to do. We will not be able to get rid of yellow. So we need something that has blue in it, which is right here. That's the only one among the three here that has a blue in it. We need blue and green. So let's make a note of it. Blue to yellow. And somehow we need something that has yellow and green. We want blue to green, so we want yellow and green. Yellow and green. Blue to green is what we're looking for. There's blue. That's not going to do the job. See, here we have red to blue. Here we have Let's make a note here. Red to blue is what we found. What we found here is red to blue, 2 to 3. And that's not going to do us anywhere. That's not going to get us anywhere. We need blue to green. We need blue to green. So here, what we're going to have to use this one. Blue to green. It has a red, and that one has a red. The red and red, we're going to cancel out, and we're going to end up with green to blue, which is exactly what we need. Blue to green to blue, same thing. So let's do that, shall we? Instead of using this one, we're going to have to use this one, green to red. Green to red times what we found here, red to blue. Red to blue, and now red is going to cancel out, and we're going to end up with green over blue. We're looking for blue over green, so when we finish it, when we finish the problem, we just take the reciprocal of it. So let's do that. Green to red, which is 2 to 1, times red to blue. Remember, it is blue to red. We need red to, or it is red to blue. It is red to blue. It's 2 to 3. So it's basically 4 over 3, which is the ratio of green to blue. Green to blue. And therefore, blue to green, which is what we need here, blue to green, is 3 to 4.
What I want you to understand here,
that was not the important part. What we just did here, that was not what we were actually interested in. What we have done so far actually was a sheer waste of time. What was it? It was a sheer waste of time. Because what we have done here is the problem in a very classical, very orthodox, very academic, very nerdy, very geeky manner. And the classical method, not only it takes too long, but there are too many places where you can mess up. If you forget to take the reciprocal, there are too many places where you mess up, and it takes time to figure out to locate the right pieces, right information here, right pieces of information here. Now we're going to do the same problem in a way that is going to be quick and dirty. I'm going to show you a quick and dirty method. It's going to go very fast, just like that, and you're going to have everything that you need in a matter of seconds. We're going to do it on the top so that you can compare all of this work that we did here with the second method. We already have the information that we need here. We can't put this information because this was not something that was given to us. That was something that we derived from here, so that doesn't belong there. And the rest of the three ratios that are given to here, they are right here. So I can erase all of this thing, and we can do the problem on the top, the quick and dirty method, okay? And here is how the quick and dirty method goes. Let's first make a list of everything that we have here. We have four colors here. We are told red to blue to green to yellow. Watch what happens, and pay attention. It's going to go. Pay attention. Let's see what happens. And we're going to start plugging in numbers here. Start plugging in values here. The first one I see is red to yellow. Red to yellow is 2 to 5. 2 to 5. Okay, that's it already. Red to yellow. As I already said twice, pay attention. So that was the first ratio we know. The second ratio we know is green to red. Green to red. Green is right there. Green to red. Red. Now we have to stop right here. We have to stop right here. This can't go any further. Green, pay attention. Green is 2, to red is 1. Are you with me so far? Now we have to pause here and take care of it. Here we have, think of these as quantities. Think of this as two marbles. And if we said that we had two marbles in the first part of the story has three parts. They are, we are given three ratios. If the first part of the story told you that we have two red marbles, then second part of the story cannot tell us all of a sudden that we only have one red marbles. The number of red marbles has to be consistent throughout the entire story. Number of marbles for a given color has to be consistent, obviously, throughout the entire story. We don't have one, we have two. We have two of these. So let's make it two. Let's multiply it by two. If you multiply this by two, you have to do the same thing here. You have to do the same thing here because the ratios have to be the same. The ratio has to be 1 to 2. The ratio of red to green has to be 1 to 2, right here, red to green. Where is it? Red to green to red. If green to red is 2 to 1, it should remain 2 to 1. So if we multiply this by 2, we must multiply by 2. We are done with this part. We took care of this one. Let's move on to this one, 3 to 5. Blue to red. I'm going to change the color one more time. We are now at blue to red. Where is blue? Sorry, blue to yellow rather. So you have to pay attention. Blue to yellow. Blue is right there, 3. To yellow. Yellow is right there, 5. Oh, lucky for us, we don't have to do anything here, because here we had 5 and here we have 5, so we don't have to do any adjustment. Here we don't have any adjustment. Now instead of 3 to 5, had they told us 3 to 10, we would have put down 10 here, we would have multiplied that by 2 and multiplied that by 2. You get the idea. But we don't have to do anything. It's 5 year and 5 year. There was a 5 year and a 5 year is the same thing. We don't have to do anything. So that's it. We are done. That's it. That's the end of the story. So here we have 2, 2, 3, 2, 4, 2, 5. And now we are ready to answer anything that they ask. The first, that's it. We are done. The story is finished. The first question they ask us is, where can I put it? The first question they ask us is, what's the ratio of red to blue? Red to blue. Well, we have two reds and we have three blues. There we go, 2 to 3. Which is exactly what we found here. The second question was, what's the ratio of blue to green? Blue to green. How many blues do we have? We have three blues. And how many green do we have? Do we have four greens? That's it, we are done. You can do all of this, mumbo jumbo, or you can do it this way and you're done in a few seconds. Instead of taking 2-3 minutes, this question can be done in a matter of a few seconds. Let's do the next one, shall we? Let's do the next problem. I want to get rid of this marble. I'm going to throw it away before I keep picking it up. This is moribund. It's dying. Let's move on to the next one. I need to erase everything obviously before we go to the next one. Number 27. Same exact idea. As soon as we put the question on the blackboard, I want you to do it yourself. We need to erase this thing. Where did my eraser thingy in the bubble go? I think it flew away. I keep doing this. Okay, let's do the new one. The next one is a little bit more complicated. It says in a solution, a ratio, this is number 27, in a solution, the ratio by volume of liquid A to B to C is 3 to 60 to 100. One more time before we go any further. We are told that we have a solution which contains three liquids and their ratio of the three liquids by volume is 3 parts to 60 parts to 100 parts A to B to C. For every 3 parts of A, we have 60 parts of B and we have 100 parts of A. And then we are told that the solution is altered. Solution is then altered. We're going to change the solution in such a way that the ratio of A to B is halved and A to C and A to C is doubled. You have to be patient while I'm writing it up. There's not much I can do here. And furthermore, we are told that in the final solution, if the final solution has 600 cubic centimeter of liquid B, how much of liquid C must we have? Here are the answer choices A, B, C, D, and E. 200, 250, 400, 500, and 1000. One more time, I'm going to read it to you and then I'm going to get out of your way. It says In a solution, the ratio by volume of liquid, LIQ is liquid, of liquid A to B to C is 3 to 60 to 100. Solution is then altered in such a way that the ratio of A to B is halved and the ratio of liquid A to C is doubled. Furthermore, the last conditions that we have here is that the final solution must contain 600 cubic centimeter of liquid B. Given the fact that we must have 600 cubic centimeter of liquid B, the question is how much liquid C must we have at the end? How much of liquid C must we have? Here are the five answer choices. I'll give you 5 seconds as always for you to be able to pause and unpause the video. Do it yourself. And if you're having struggle with it, if you're having trouble with it, don't give up. Don't try. Don't give up. You must try. Try it one or two times before. Because once you saw the solution, obviously it's quite straightforward. The key here, I need the room, so I'm going to have to erase all of this thing. I'm going to have to erase all of this problem because we need the room. The key here is to manipulate only two liquids at a time. Manipulate the keys. Here's the solution. The key here is to manipulate only two liquids at a time. And if that's what's giving you trouble, there is your second chance here to do the problem yourself. And that's what we're going to do. Don't try to manipulate everything together. You will never get anywhere. Manipulate only two liquids at a time. So let's do that on the top. Remember, the ratio is 3 to 60 to 100. And finally, we need 600 of one of them. I don't know which one it was. We'll get to that in a second. So, first parts first. First, we are told that A to B is halved. A to B, we are told, is halved. But before, A to B was 3 to 60. 3 to 60 is the original. That ratio is now half. There are two ways you can go about doing that. There are two ways you can go about doing it. One is to simply take 1.5 of this to 60, which just half the ratio, or you could leave the 3 the way it was and go to 120. Either way is fine. We just half A to B. We just half the ratio of A to B. That part is done. Let's move on to the second part. Let's move on to second part. A to C. We are told that A to C, what about A to C? I forgot what it was. We are doubled. A to C is doubled. So let's do that. A to C was, A is 3 and C is 100. So instead of 3 to 100, now we're going to have 6 to 100. That's all it is. We just doubled it. That part is also done. That part is also done. We took care of it. Now let's put everything together, shall we? Let's put everything together and see where we go. A to B to C to D. A to B in the final ratio is, A to B used to be 3 to 60, but we halved it, so now it's 3 to 120. 3 to 120. A to C used to be 3 to 100, but now it's going to be 6 to 100. A to C is 6 to 100. 6 to 100. Well, we have to pay attention. 6 is A. We have to pay attention. I have to pay attention. A is 6. 6 goes here. 6 to C, which is 100. Now we have to stop and take care of it. We have to take care of the fact that in the first half of the story, we have to take care of the fact that in the first half of the story, we have 3 parts A, in the second parts we have 6. So this has to be 6 as well. So if we can double this one, we have to double this one. There was no D. There was no blasted D. I don't know where D is coming from. What the hell am I thinking? There are only 3. That's it, we are done. So there was no C. There was no D. The last thing we have to keep in mind is the conditions that we are told that the final solution must contain 600 parts of B. How many B's do we have? We have 240. We have 240. I'm going to squeeze this out here so that we have some more room, because we need room here. only because this is getting too crowded, to C, and C was 6 to 100. Let's put them down here like this, 6 to 240 to 100.
No.
We don't want 240, we want 600. Final solution must have 600. So let's see what we're going to do. We could figure out 600 divided by 240 is how much. We can go about doing it, but I'm not going to do that, so pay attention. First, I'm going to divide everything by 2. So it becomes 3 to 120 to 50. Divide everything by 2. We don't want 120, we want 600. So multiply everything by 5. Times 5, times 5, times 5, and we're done. Now we have 600 of B. We have 15 of A. And we have 250 of C. And what is the question asking? Question was asking, how much C must we have? Well, there we go. We have 250 parts of C. There you go. It's a solution, it's a liquid C, but the answer choice is B. Don't get confused. The answer is 250. What I would like you to do now
is to do the same problem one more time. If this one gave you some trouble and if you were unable to do it yourself, now that you know the technique,
what I would like you to do is to do the next problem all by yourself. I'm going to put the problem on the blackboard. It is a very similar problem, only the numbers have changed, the concept, the methodology, the procedure, everything is going to be the same. The numbers are going to be changed. New problem. You do it yourself. Again, I need the room, so we're going to have to erase everything. And I keep losing the bloody thing that I keep making, and they keep flying away. Okay, so we're done with all of this thing. You understood what we did here. First, you manipulate A to B. A to B used to be 3 to 60. We are told it is half. If it's half, which means it's either 1.5 to 60, but I don't like to deal with fractions, so instead of doing 1.5 to 60, I did 3 to 120. It's the same concept. Is the same concept. So that we did that, 3 to 120, and then we are told that A to C is double. A to C used to be 3 to 100. A to C is 3 to 100. If you double the ratio, instead of 3 to 100, it's 6 to 100. People put that here, 6 to 100. And we realize here that here we have 6 parts here, here we have 3 parts here, so we have to multiply this by 2 to make it 6. As soon as you multiply this by 3 by 2, we have to multiply this by 2, because the ratio has to be the same. Ratio has to be 3 to 120. And we do that, we bring it down here, and then we adjust the final figure based on how much of a given liquid we have in the problem. They're going to tell you that we have this much of liquid C or liquid A or whatever it is, and based on that condition, figure out what's the other liquid that they're looking for. That's all. Problem number 28. In a solution, the ratio by volume of liquid A to B to C is 2 to 5 to 7. Solution is then altered such that even if you are unable to read my handwriting, I always read as I write, so that you have no reason to complain that you can't read the bloody thing. The solution is then altered such that the ratio of A to B is doubled and the ratio of A to C is tripled. Final solution must contain 30 milliliter of B. How much of C must we have? How much of C must we have if we are given the fact that at the end of the story
we must have exactly 30 milliliter of liquid B. Do it yourself. Now that we know how to do it, it's very simple, very straightforward. It should go quite fast. It should go quite fast. I should give you the answer choices as well, make it more interesting. A, B, C, D, and E. 21, 24, 28, 30, and 42. So if you did the problem already, and the answer choice that you arrived at, because I forgot to put the answer choices first in the beginning. So if the answer choice that you arrived at is not one of these five, then redo it. Pause the video one more time and redo it. If it is one of them, then that's what you want to pick. Let's get going. So we're going to manipulate two liquids at a time, as we said before. So let's first talk about A to B. A to B is doubled. So A to B originally was, A to B was 2 to 5. 2 to 5 will become 4 to 5. We just doubled it. We are told that A to C is tripled. A was 2 to 7. 2 to 7 will become, we want to triple it. We want to triple the ratio, so it becomes 6 to 7. Let's put everything together. A to B to C. I don't know why I keep writing D. There is no blasted D. A to B to C. How much is A? A is 4. How much is B? B is 5. And here we have A is 6. Here the A is 6. And here we have 7. So are you with me so far? So those are the two ratios we have here. Let's keep them separate here. This part and this part. So A to C we were given, the ratio was 2 to 7, and we were told that it's tripled. So we tripled it. Instead of 2 to 7, it became 6 to 7. So we put here 6 to 7. A to B we were told was 2 to 5. Instead of 2 to 5, we have 4 to 5. We doubled it. And we put it here. We insert all the figures here. A is 4, B is 5, and here we have A is 6, and here C is 7. As you can see, here we have 4, here we have 6. That's not going to do it. We have to have the same number. So let's multiply and make it the same number before we do anything else. We have to have the same units for a given liquid. Here we have 4 parts, here we have 6 parts, that's more than 2. So what I'm going to do is multiply this by 2, multiply that by 3, make it 12, and multiply this by 2, make it 12. There you go. And since we multiply this by 3, I must multiply this by 3. It says final solution must contain 30 of B. Tell you what, that actually makes it easy. Why don't we multiply, instead of having a common denominator of 12, instead of having the 12 units here, let's make it 24 because we need 30. We need 30. Or we could continue here. This is 15. We could continue here, make it 30, multiply this by 2. Oh, I shouldn't have done all of this thing. I'm gonna stop here. Let's take one thing at a time. Otherwise we're gonna get confused. So one more time. Here we had, let me start again, because I did too. It does not pay to try to save 2 seconds. There are smart way of saving times in the exam, and there are stupid way of saving times. What I was about to do was a stupid, idiotic way of saving time. It wasn't a smart way because there are too many chances you're taking there. I'm taking too many chances because I'm trying to do too much at once. Let's just do one thing, one step at a time. So A is 4, B is 5, I'm going to take my sweet time. A is 6, I'm going to take my sweet time. And get what we get to it. So there we go. So we're going to start again. Here we have 6, here we have 12. So I'm just going to do what comes to my mind. I'm not going to worry about what the question is asking at the end. I'm just going to do what comes to my mind, which is I'm going to see 12 here. I see 12 here. 4 and 6, I see 12. Multiply this by 3. Make it 12. As soon as I multiply this by 3, I must multiply that by 3. Multiply this by 2 to make it 12. If I do that, I must do that here. And let's do one step at a time. So now we have A, which is 12, as you can see, 12, to B, which is 15, to C, which is 14. Watch what happens. And now we do our last step. Why should we do everything together? we have 15 parts of B. B is 15 parts, that won't do. We need 30 parts of B, we are told. So now multiply everything by 2. Multiply this by 2, multiply this by 2, and multiply this by 2, and you won't go wrong. And we are done. We have 30 parts of B. We have 30 parts of B. 15 times 2 is 30, which means we must have 24 of A and 28 of C. What is the question asking? How much of C must be? Pay attention what they are asking for, because here we have 24, which is right here. Here we have 28, which is right there. Make sure you pick the right one that they are asking for. How much of C is they looking for, not A? C is 28. Liquid C is 28, which also happens to be, answer C. Which also happens to be the answer choice C. That was it for today. Tomorrow we'll do part 5 of 6, which will contain problems dealing with time and work. Time and work, two problems, two very similar problems, just like we did the two problems just now with the same concept. We're going to do two problems dealing with time and work, dealing with also involving the notion of ratios and proportions. All right, bye now.